Betances is on the field, hand bleeding everywhere, still wants to be out there and is able to get out of the jam. What have you learned about him as a competitor this season?
I just like the way he's been able to slow some things down. You know, we saw early in the season some situations kind of speed up on him, and he's done a much better job at that. And then tonight, you know, he finds himself in a little bit of trouble, but what I liked is he kept making pitches. And they had some tough at-bats against him, but, you know, he kept pounding the strike zone with both his fastball and his breaking balls, and he came up with a lot of big pitches in that inning.
When you see the blood on his hand and on his pants, is there any thought there, what's happening, we might need to get him out of there?
Unfortunately, we're used to seeing it. Sometimes I have to go out there, but with Larry wanted to pay him a visit just to talk to him. And when he came back, he said he was bleeding, but he said it's a non-issue. So just something, unfortunately, he has to deal with sometimes. We try and stay on it as best we can.
You seemed as fired up as anybody when he got that final out.
I thought it was a well-played game and, you know, just grinding away. And obviously it got a little bit tight there in the ninth. And I was just proud of Dylan for really thought the quality of his pitches, even though he got into some trouble, he continued to make quality pitches, and no matter the situation or the pitch before, he was able to keep going.
Is Andujar okay?
Yeah, Miggy's okay.
What's the difference in Lynn in a performance like this and when he's not making pitches? What's the difference in the stuff?
You know, I mean, I thought he did a good job today of mixing in some off-speed pitches. He got some big outs with the slider. But really, it comes down to his fastball. And, he can ride that four-seam up. We saw 95 with that four-seam fastball that he can get to the top of the zone. But, you know, his calling card is still that sinker. And I thought he threw some really good sinkers, too, that had really good depth to it. But, it's strikes. You know, he's had a little bit of trouble this year, with some walks. So if he's commanding the strike zone, there's a fearlessness about the way he goes about things.
How much of a lift has Austin's offense been at times for you guys this year?
Yeah, it's been big. I thought he had a great night behind the plate. And that at bat he had, it's one thing to, go opposite field with a home run, obviously a huge hit for us at the time. But I think what is just as exciting to me was getting to that pitch. Some of the pitches he was able to lay off and spoil the quality of the at-bat that got him finally to a pitch that he could drive and he didn't miss it.
That home run, his 10th of the season, you now have 10 players in double digits for home runs. Even knowing the amount of talent you had offensively coming in, is that still a remarkable feat?
It is. And obviously we've gotten production from a lot of different places, maybe even that we didn't expect coming into the year. Guys have had to play more. Young guys have really taken over, obviously, significant roles. So the fact that we've gotten production from everywhere, I think, is a big reason we're having a strong year.